All right, what's good? I'm back with another video, and today we are going to be talking about the Houston Rockets. Now, I have been making a lot of, Rockets videos, and I made the Fred VanVleet video a couple days ago or a week ago, so go check that out if you wanted to hear what I have to say on the Fred VanVleet signing. But yeah, 3 years, 130 million, 43 million a year guaranteed. It's crazy. I just don't understand. I understand that we need a veteran point guard. He's not even a veteran. I know we want to compete now. Sure, let's get Fred VanVleet. I mean, I accept at this point that Amen Thompson or KPJ is not going to start. But 43 million a year for a wannabe Drake who just throws up shots. He's basically like just a better version of Eric Gordon. It's crazy. Now, Fred VanVleet better average 25. He better do something crazy. He better get us to the playoffs playing something. He better do something crazy for us. Now, in terms of Dylan Brooks, it's complicated because the dude is weird. That's all I gotta say. The dude is very weird. But obviously, I love the defense. We need that. We need some personnel on this team. We need some identity. Dylan Brooks will bring that. And I was always fine with us bringing Dylan Brooks as long as he doesn't cause too much drama. But that's not a promise, obviously. But my biggest problem is 80 million. 80 million for Dylan Brooks. I understand we got money to spend, but we don't need to be throwing money, bro. Like 80 million for Dylan Brooks is crazy. We also signed Jeff Green. Obviously, he's not going to do anything. Just sit on the bench, mentor the young guys. That can help. But last signing is Jock Landale. So I don't even know who this dude was. Some white dude with the mullet from the Suns. We signed him, gave him like 20, $30 million. We were trying to get Brook Lopez. We traded away Garuba, Ty Ty Washington, Fernando. We traded away a lot of players to free up cap space for Brook Lopez, and he kind of just walked away, went back to the Bucks, and we got to downgrade to Jock Landale. So yeah, don't know too much about him. Hopefully he can play defense, catch alley-oops. That's about all we need from him. But yeah, we got a pretty good roster. We're looking at some solid pieces. We got some young players. We got, Fred VanVleet, and we got Dylan Brooks. Maybe now that Josh Christopher's gone, Dylan Brooks can be Jalen Green's new partner, but hey, who knows? But yeah, these contracts are going to look very bad pretty soon if Fred VanVleet can't hit shots, if we're again the 15th seed in the West or 14th, and Dylan Brooks is doing nothing but chirping other players and breaking shots. It's going to look pretty bad. We also do have around 20 to $30 million left in free agency, and there are still some free agents left. So we'll see who we get. We have pretty much every single roster spot filled. So it just all depends on upgrading at this point. But yeah. But obviously, no James Harden. Looks like he's gonna go to the Clippers. No Jaylen Brown. He still hasn't got the extension from the Celtics. But at this point, I don't even know what we could put together. I guess maybe something around KPJ. But they would probably want Amen Thompson, and low key, I would be down for that. As long as we don't give up Jalen Green, that's the only player I don't want to give up. But yeah, pretty weird and interesting offseason for the Houston Rockets. Now, giving Fred VanVleet $130 million, you would assume he would be starting. I still would want Amen Thompson to start or even KPJ, just because young players, we're here to develop them. I think Dylan Brooks is going to start because we got Cam Whitmore, we got Tari Eason, but we want a more, veteran kind of player, better at defense. I would be fine with that. But yeah, I'm kind of excited for next season. New coach Ime Udoka. Again, I don't really know what Raphael Stone, what his plan is, what his vision is, throwing around all this money to whoever, whenever. But yeah, whatever he's doing, better work out. Now, these crazy players and crazy contracts and signings are not the only weird things going on with the Houston Rockets, because there has been some crazy Jalen Green and Josh Christopher drama, or not drama, but some leaked footage of them. Go back and watch the past two videos behind this one, and you will see why. There's been leaked footage now, two videos of Jalen Green and Josh Christopher dry humping each other and both coming out the closet. So yeah, pretty weird stuff going inside this Rockets organization. So yeah, I feel like I've talked about this Jalen Green and Josh Christopher stuff already too much, too long. I've already made two videos about it. Now I'm talking about it again. But Jabari Smith, apparently he's like a coach now. Dude just got drafted last year, and I guess he's calling it a career already because it looks like Jabari Smith is coaching the team now. But yeah, some video came out yesterday, I think, or 2 days ago, where Jabari Smith apparently coaching a bunch of seniors in high school or juniors. And he basically 1v1 this junior and got absolutely cooked by him. I think the score was like 21 to like 10 or something like that. So yeah, not a good look for Jabari Smith. You know, former number 3 pick. Didn't look too good in his first year, but you know, he's a rookie. Also, Ime Udoka, Jalen Green, two very big freaks, team up in Houston. Might get pretty scary this season. We'll see. But yeah, that's going to be it for this video. All the crazy stuff that is going on with the Houston Rockets right now. Comment down below if you guys want to see a video on any kind of NBA rumor, NBA trade, or signing. Let me know down in the comments, and I will see you guys in the next video.